Now, today's episode of Big Black Crypto, we got to be on pushing like episode 48 right now or something like that. Well, this is HAPPSTV, and they're currently in beta, as you can see. You know, it's interesting because they've also got a neat little system in regards to coins, being able to exchange that with your favorite broadcasters. And let me tell you a little bit about what HAPPS is. HAPPS helps you broadcast like a pro. HAPPS broadcasters include journalists, podcasters, vloggers, artists, musicians, and activists. It's for anyone who wants to broadcast for free, build a community, and make money. Viewers can comment and ask questions within live broadcasts, follow broadcasters to get notifications when they go live, and financially support their work via monthly sponsorships or one-time payments. So don't worry, I won't leave you out. I'll also include my invite link in the description down below. But for a quick run through, this is the site, and it's pretty straightforward. You can choose what you want to follow, who you want to follow. You could even go through my feed just to take a look at what's available. And it really is exciting because we talk about doing video on Holochain, and this might be one of those applications that you sync into, you know, HumHive or HOLO. It's quite interesting. So let's give it a quick run through. You can stream everywhere and get paid. HAPPS is the place to find a community of friends, fans, and fellow creators. You can use our tools to start a show and get paid to go live. So it really is exciting as far as like what their offerings are. You are able to reach your audience through multi-streaming. I think you can stream over five sites, I believe. You got Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and other platforms at the same time. Even your guests can too. You can find your voice, find your audience, join the thriving HAPPS community of broadcasters and viewers. You can multicast to all your social media platforms and your guest platforms too. Get paid by viewers via subscriptions and rewards. Why do people love HAPPS? Well, there's over 25 million views and growing. So the question is, what's holding you back from broadcasting your success? You know, building your audience and cultivating a series. It's still in its infancy, so there's great opportunity to really grow on that platform. And if you have more questions, you can definitely reach out to them via email. They're also on YouTube, so if you got questions about how to set up, well, they've got a complete overview of HAPPSTV, as you can see in their tutorial here. And if you want to see more videos that they have to offer, by all means, jump in, check it out. Like I said, they are fairly new, so I'm kind of curious as to like, hey, you're in beta right now, and what's the next path forward? Like, it's very, very, very interesting to me. If you're in the Holochain environment, you're kind of curious, right? The name HAPPS stand out to you. It could be in relation to the slang, you know what I mean? Like, what's happening? You know, what's the HAPPS? But also too, remember, regardless, there's API configurations, and this is something that you will see, you know, you being able to integrate into HumHive down the road. Again, this is a playlist of all their videos. There's plenty to dive into, to watch, to, you know, further your understanding as to what the real capabilities on this platform are. And so for you, those of you, especially, you know, similar to myself, who are interested in, you know, in curating an audience, being able to monetize what they do, and as well, you know, any form of journalism or independent coverage, you know, turns this into a marketable moment. And that's what's really unique about this. Again, you can check out more in throughout the application. Again, I encourage you to sign up, to check it out, to really get familiar with it. And again, I'm not trying to insinuate that this is a application for Holochain. I've checked it out. I don't see anything beyond the word HAPP. But at the same time too, I know what this means for us who are, you know, growing in this space. There is something I can interact with. It's interoperable. I couldn't find anything in GitHub. So again, I'm not insinuating anything. I'm simply, you know, letting you know that as more HAPPS become available, well, guess what? Now you have something to plug and play with in terms of applications like HumHive, right? You know, here they talk about the stewardship of story with natural lore technology, right? They're currently in beta as well. They're an open source application that helps you create and share with your hives, right? So again, they're not a server, and everything in your hive lives are on your device. So what you get the advantage of is when we talk about interoperability and utilizing plugins, you know, what do you have the ability to do when HumHive goes live? You know, realistically, you'll be able to utilize a streaming service like HAPPSTV in your storefront down the road. So these are things for people to consider. And, you know, how long until you're able to do the same with HOLO? I remember somebody asking me, oh, is HOLO a functional app? Here you go. Here you go. I deal with a lot of questions that get asked, but I don't know if they ever get researched. If you go to HOLO.com, Yes, they're a functional app, and it'll be interesting when they integrate more plugins down the road. And I'm looking forward to being able to stream at a certain point on the app itself. Again, they are a functional app. If you're taking a look, this is what it looks like on the iPhone. They've been working steadily. They've been in beta for almost a year now. So again, they are a functional app. And why is this unique? Why is something like Happs.tv unique? Well, it's because you're also able to connect to Twitter, right? So we've seen Twitter sort of reach out and try to become this marketplace by allowing developers access to API protocols in which they're able to connect other additional services to Twitter. We've seen this with review, in which you're able to enhance your experience with your followers by allowing writers and publishers to send editorial newsletters. So you can write your subscription letter weekly and publish it, and your audience will get access to it. So if that's of interest to you, that's why something like Happs.tv is unique, because, you know, down the road, streaming, you might be able to just, you know, connect into the spaces portion and stream only audio, maybe video. This is a feature I want to explore more down the road, and I'm just sharing that with you, that there are these opportunities to grow your audience and to offer a more rounded experience overall for everyone. And again, check out their Twitter, follow them on Twitter. It's worth the follow. They've got 20,000 followers, and it's by all means not a tiny company. Like, they are pushing boundaries. Now, here's how they stack up against the competition. Compared to StreamYard, who charges $49 a month, Restream charges $49 a month, Melon charges $15 a month. They all offer unlimited streaming. They're all web-based studios. But hold on, it's only Happs that offers a mobile application. Now, it's also Happs that's the only one that offers multicasting destinations. They're the only one that allows guest multicast. They do offer custom RTMP. Now, here's what's unique. Broadcast, recording, unlimited forever. Others have 4 hours for 15 days, 10 hours for 15 days. X, YouTube requires you to, record for you up to 12 hours. Here, they allow unlimited recording. You're allowed up to 8 on-screen guests, on-screen comments. You're allowed graphics. You've got background. Overlays are coming soon. So this could also be a disruptor for OBS. Whoa. Things to consider, right? Or, you know, how do you enhance your OBS experience with Happs? Like, if you're, this is a new application, so it's worth it to engage, to understand, and be around as it develops and grows into a better offering for the user end experience. They've got portrait output, they got VIP creator support. You can earn money via monthly sponsorships. You can earn money via one-off awards. You can display donation goals on screen, and you can also just focus on your community. So that's something I'll explain in greater detail in terms of how, you know, the monetization works. This is the founder, Mark Goldman. He's a special case. Just to give you a quick idea about him, it's really special character. In 1995, he was recruited by News Corp to build its first digital satellite TV service in Latin America. As president and chief operating officer of Sky Latin America, he oversaw the establishment of local operating companies throughout the region, the development of a pan-regional programming marketing strategy, the construction of state-of-the-art digital broadcasting facility, and over $700 million of financing transactions. Where do we go from here? In 2003, he joined former U.S. Vice President Al Gore and entrepreneur Joe Hyatt to form Current TV. So, Current TV, that's the name of the brand, and it was so successful, you know, as a profitable entity, that the TV network reached 60 million homes in 3 countries and was a leading social news website. In 2013, that same company was sold to Al Jazeera for $500 million. So if you want to get an idea as to what this, you know, what Mark Goldman's background is as the co-founder and chief executive officer at Happs, he is definitely great belief in the success and viability of this project off of his previous workings and dealings. Now, in addition to Happs, he also serves as the chairman of Podium Audio, a top 10 audios book company. So this is tremendous, in my opinion. You know, as far as, you know, about them, how many employees they got roughly about 11 to 50 employees at any given time. Here they say they got 43. I'm very enamored by this application. If you want to learn more about Happs, you can head over to their Medium blog. You know, they've got an excellent 10-minute introduction that was written back in November of 2020 about what Happs is. And again, if you want to learn more about what Happs is, you can head over to their blog site on medium.com, Happs News, Introduction to Broadcasting on Happs. And like I said, They do have a mobile application, so you can use it on iOS. You can start broadcasting on Android today. You know, just give it a quick scroll. It's worth the 10-minute read to gain insights. If you want to know what you can broadcast, they allow all kinds of things. So political commentary, an interview with multiple people, on the ground reporting from a protest march, drawing a political cartoon, a tour of the Louvre in Paris, sea life at an aquarium in Chicago, instant recap of sports highlights, live concert with song requests, storm chasing, border wall, indigenous protests, much more. You know, if you're a young individual and you're trying to figure out where to begin, you know, in terms of whatever you want to cover, well, this is the type of, you know, HAPP that'll enable you to do that. You know, to be your own reporter, to be your own independent journalist, to cover things as they happen. You know, one of the top tier benefits to broadcasting on HAPPS. Now you got to ask yourself, what are the top benefits of broadcasting on HAPPS? Reasons you'll love HAPPS. You know, one, you get top tier guests for your broadcasts. So you can really collaborate and grow in your community. You can monetize your work. This has been an issue for a lot of people that have been trying to enterprise, you know, in some of these digital spaces. This is an opportunity to find value, create value for others, and for others to reflect that value and appreciation in your work, you know, through the either buy me a coffee function or through the sponsor function, in which you'll get recurring subscriptions. You can also reach a wider audience. I've seen some people who've got followings of 13,000 individuals. I didn't know that this platform was that big. I wasn't expecting it to be that big, but it's actually quite massive. You can get world-class support. So their experts will definitely guide you through each step. But believe me when I say this, the video tutorials are very thorough. You know, it's a fairly simple process to get up and going. You know, one, if you're already logged into some of your applications like YouTube, Twitter, it's very easy to cross over. I'm excited. Viewers can also interact with HAPPS broadcasts in a variety of ways. So you can subscribe to broadcasters. You can support broadcasters. You can also comment on live broadcasts and ask questions of the hosts or interviewees in real time. So if you're wondering, how do you start broadcasting? Well, here they're saying you can reach out to, you know, Pete Bittner at HAPPSTV for a walkthrough. But I'm telling you, just head over to HAPPSTV. It is a lot easier to sign up, to get started, and, you know, just to utilize it. It's a fairly intuitive process. It took me under, you know, 5 minutes to really get flying on the app. So, you know, if there are any tips, you know, here they say broadcast on a regular and frequent schedule, check your lighting and audio, and use the broadcast studio to upgrade your broadcast. Like, they'll even coach you up on your lighting. There's a video for just about everything. When we talk about interviewing multiple guests, yes, you can interview up to 7 guests on your broadcast. You can interact with your viewers, use the audio controls in the broadcast studio to adjust levels for your guests or any pre-recorded video. So that's an advantage. And of course, they're very accessible. Just reach out to them, contact them for any questions or opportunities at one-on-one demos, or even to see how they might fit into your own ecosystem. This is top-notch stuff. And if you're wondering about, you know, how to become a top journalist on HAPPS, again, just reach out to them. If you've got, you know, the credentials and you want to be a player in their space, and you feel like you've got the background, just reach out to them. Don't be shy about it. And how do payments and awards work on HAPPS? So basically, the way they do it is they do a payout period, which is a net 30. So I think that's like every 30 days or something like that. Eligible broadcasters receive 70% of the monthly recurring sponsorship revenue after applicable taxes and fees are deducted. Now, once your account balance reaches about 200, a payment request can be made and will be scheduled for 30 days after the concurrent account balance. So you got to wait 30 days for the balance to clear. A record of all your earnings and available balance can be found in your setting. HAPPS do not charge any fees for payments. However, their payment processor charges a small fee of 2.9% plus 30 cents. So you're always going to get charged 30%. Sorry, you're always going to get charged 30 cents and then 2.9% of the overall transaction. And, you know, if you're eligible, you're going to get up to 70. You're going to receive 70% of the monthly recurring sponsorship revenue. So, I mean, you know, you could take that how you want it. But again, it's another opportunity for someone who doesn't want to go through a paywall in order to get started, right? There's no minimum amount of followers you have. If you've got content, if you've got an audience, and you bring them over, guess what? You've got potential. So that's the difference here. Also, anyone on Happs is eligible to earn awards. Viewers can give awards to broadcasters that can be cashed for real money. Awards can be sent using coins purchased on, or earned by being active on Happs. So this kind of, you know, takes on this like little NFT play. It's not really like an NFT in any sense of the word, but it's just the notion of, here's this graphic. I think you're worthy of it. Here you go. You've got it. That award, you know, the coins can literally be converted into cash. So, you know, if you're looking for like kind of like this ecosystem play, this would be it. It's not like TradingView where you're getting coins that, you know, may in the future have a monetary value. Here, their coins actually have a monetary value. And what happens in the future, hypothetically, when those coins, you know, become convertible toward, you know, their own payment service, you know, their own crypto related service. Like, there's nothing stopping these guys from having a HAP coin, you know what I mean? Or their own tokenized asset. And this might just be a way of testing, you know, the transactional ability in app. So when I say like it's good to get in these spaces early, hell yeah. And if the coins already have a monetary value, hell yeah. Like, don't be late to the party. I am telling you, definitely get your ass on this. So are there any reasons to broadcast on Happs? There's a ton of reasons. So again, here they're talking about broadcasting like a pro and what Instagram does for photo filters and TikTok does for video editing. You know, Happs does for enhancing live broadcast. That's what this is about. It's about enhancing your live broadcast experience and not just to, you know, one space, to multiple spaces. You can really reach more viewers and connect easily to social media accounts, simultaneously reaching followers across platforms such as Twitter, Periscope, Facebook, YouTube, etc. with a single live broadcast. Plus, Happs track your broadcast interest and engagements and spreads, so you get a really good analytical overview of your reach. Now, we keep talking about this, getting paid to broadcast, because guess what? It's worth it. Like, you put in the effort, and if people like what they see, it's very simple. There's no, hey, it's $5.99, it's $15.99. It's kind of more or less pay as you go. And I remember having this issue with like the whole notion of like, you know, pay as you go, not really liking the name. But then at the same time too, it's, you know, there's a market for everybody and not everybody wants to commit to $20 a month, to $50 a month, to $10 a month. Here it's, yeah, what do you want to commit? You like this? Okay, well, my budget might be $5. My budget might be $1. My budget might be 50. Maybe a philanthropist might like you a lot and just, here's $1,000 a month. You know what I mean? Because everybody has their way of wanting to support someone, but everyone has a different budget in terms of what they'd be willing to commit. And that support feature is very unique to this platform. I see many subscription models and they always want recurring payment, but you, in some cases, you can't set or adjust. Or there's a base minimum. Here, there is no minimum. If I like, I can, you know, and but all I can afford is $1. You're getting $1. But if I like you and I can afford $20, $15 or more, you're getting that. I've seen, you know, some people with as high as, you know, I've seen an artist. They are an artist, like true to the word, painter, you know, sketch, like real artistic medium. I'm not limiting art forms to that, but I mean like real artistic mediums. And yeah, they've got 500 plus reoccurring subscriptions. Now, how much each subscription is chipping in, that's irrelevant. It's just the point though, you know, people talk about having difficulty monetizing themselves. Again, you won't know until you give people the opportunity to engage with you on a platform that allows you to leverage your skill sets, your talents, and your offerings to a community. And that's the beauty of being able to more in a more engaged fashion with your viewers. You can collaborate with peers too. So again, depending on your community, we've all got friends in different spaces, and this is one of those spaces that allows you to really collaborate in compelling fashion. Now, this is what I love about this app. You're eliminating the gate. So if you're frustrated by the way media organizations control broadcasting, you're taking the middleman out of the equation. You know what I mean? So now any broadcaster anywhere in the world can access Happs for free and decide what to broadcast. The result is an egalitarian, democratic approach to broadcast. And of course, you can speak freely. Corporate-controlled broadcasters have to live within a world that often cares more about profits than people. You can care more about people than profits and still net a profit. That's, you know, that's where there's real opportunities. And what you end up with is a safe haven for truth tellers and independent voices. You're going beyond the soundbite. You're going to choose the format that fits for you and work within it until you find something that's conducive to your growth as far as like the format that you use. And over time, you're going to get verified as you build trust. So the Happs platform has badges that they use to identify broadcasters. So, and that's clearly displayed so viewers can have proper context on whomever they're watching. Guidelines that build trust, you know, like any good community, they do have guidelines that are, you know, that, you know, if you violate, will make you subject for media removal or delisting. So again, pay attention to those things. And you also are enabled to see that biases are revealed. Let's be real. Here they don't hide it. Broadcasters have biases and it shows up in the stories they choose to cover and how they tell those stories. At Happs, we want broadcasters to feel free to reveal those biases so viewers can evaluate the reporting with the proper context in mind. One of the things we talk about YouTube is, you know, who's syndicated, who's owned, who's bought. You know, these Muppet made maxis aren't made men's, you know, but at the same time too, it, you know, people are biased to what they're invested in and what they're holding. So from a crypto sense, this, you know, it's a perfect space for an audience to migrate, in which for someone to really be in control of their situation. There's nothing wrong with your bias. Here's another thing that I liked about it too. You're able to fight fake news. So the truth embedded in the act of going live is the antidote to fake news. While it's easy to edit footage together to misconstrue events and facts, it's much more difficult to do that live by going live. Happs lets you give viewers the raw intel. And again, if you want to know the origin story of how it all started, definitely go head over to medium.com/HappsNews, HAPPSNEWS, and you can find out all about them. You don't need to edit anything. Just take us there. A Q&A with Happs co-founders Mark Goldman and David Newman. Again, they're also on Instagram. So if you are using Instagram and that's your preferred app and you want to learn more about them there, by all means. But remember, when I said you could stream to just about anywhere, this is like one of those spaces you can stream to. This is their LinkedIn tree. So if you want to, again, read the Happs blog, follow their Twitter, follow them on Instagram, or just download the app, you know, based on your OS of preference, whether that's iOS or Android, you can do that there too. Make it here. Happs was built on the core belief that when streamers work together as partners, creators, the community, and the global conversation all benefit exponentially. Happs is entirely focused on developing the connections between creators and the communities that support them. In an algorithmically driven world where streamers are forced to compete with each other for ever-shrinking pieces of attention, Happs is focused on their collaborative success. So, and mind you, when we talk about collaborative, you know, success, this is another thing that would, you know, Zoom was great, but I think this might be something that might be better for, you know, group sessions, considering you're able to get up to 7 and I would test it out, I think, for like the next ecosystem session or something, because so far I'm a fan of it. I'm a big fan. And again, if you want to check it out, by all means, head over to the site. Like I said, they are in beta and you can go whether, you know, based on your feed, what you like, or you can just check out what's trending. Oh, this is super nice. I like this. I can say, hello, I'm from Toronto. You know what I mean? Here, you could already see the Happs team already get, yo, my man already made 20 cents USD. You got a huge congratulations. Yo, the developers are in here. That's the other thing too. Like I nearly fell out my chair when I was like, how did I get 7 subscribers? The moment you sign up, you know, the founders and devs, they rock with you. They rock with you. So if there's any question about like how cementing I am with this, it's, you've got a reward system. I could, you know, send my man 200 coins. I only got 310 right now. But if you want to demonstrate, you know, the value. So this is where we see that monetary opportunity, right? You get $1 for each 1,000 coins you get. So if you want to, so if your goal is to be really successful, you know, at the 2,000 USD mark, you're going to want to earn probably close to about 200,000 coins a month. However that happens, however you do it, great. So if you're an artist of any kind, a performer, a broadcaster, like there's a lot of awards to be had. And they, you know, I like the style of them, man. Like that's what you want to aim for if you're a presenter of any kind. You want to aim for Happs Gold. So there you have it. 1,000 coins is equal to $1 USD. Man, this guy's got pipes, man. Somebody give this man gold. And again, like I'm a fan of the platform. It's not overly saturated. Here's how you can connect into some of the other applications. Instagram, Twitch, Periscope, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter. You know, set up your profile right away. And when you know, set up your location, you know, I'm from Toronto. Boom. Put me in the heart of Toronto and sort of gave me, you know, my own locale. So it's really nice to have that in the backdrop of my profile pic. You want to get a vibe on how you can earn coin? Right now I've got 310 coins. Just setting up your profile alone will get you, I think, an additional 210 coins. You get 100 just for signing up. So the moment you create an account, you got 100 coin. You want to get to your first USD dollar? Invite some friends. Invite 3 more friends, you earn 100 coins. Every couple of friends, you know, if 10 friends join, you got 1,000 coins. That's how you earn your first dollar right there. Subscribe to broadcasters to get notified when they go live. Boom, you get an extra 200 coins. Subscribe to an additional 4 more users for an extra 20 coins. You, as a philanthropist, sponsor a broadcaster to support their work, you get 1,000 coins. Community cultivator, comment on 100 or more posts, you get 300 plus coins. Social butterfly, connect through more social accounts, you get 500 plus coins. You know what I mean? So the moment you set this up to broadcast across multiple streams, you're getting 500 coins. You know, this right here, completing your profile, 100 coins. Thoroughly read the Happs community guidelines and check the box at the bottom of the page, 100 coins. Log in one day in a row, get more coins every day you log in, plus 10. Now, why is this significant? Look at a platform like KuCoin. The thing about KuCoin that made it successful was that they got like candy rewards. Every day you log in, you get a reward. So next target, log in tomorrow for 20 more coins. So every day you log in, you're going to get some coins until that changes. In beta, you get the most rewards. So I would, like I said, get in on this app. Have some fun, enjoy it before the reward system changes. You only have to broadcast once a week to get your 500 coins. So I'll probably end up broadcasting on this fairly soon. If you want to buy coins, you know, this is one of the faster ways to do it, because you never know, right? How they're going to, you know, do this, right? At a certain point, you never know, right? Are the coins that they're just distributing right now set for a limited amount? You know, there's no information on the tokenomic or the reward structure as far as what I can see. I wasn't able to find a white paper. Like, this is a private company for the most part, but you know, something like 115,000 coins might only be worth $200 forever, or it might be worth $1,000 tomorrow, right? It all depends on what they do going forward. Because, you know, if they were to tie this to a crypto-based asset, now you have a complete game changer, right? You can always swap these coins for a native currency to the platform. They're just coins. It's just a payment structure, right? When we're talking about, I remember Acorn did a video in regards to Catcoin. And it was, you know, a play on words, but basically like the movement of a currency. You could create your own currency, attribute it to whatever fiat-based real-world currency, and matriculate the value from that. Now, here we see it in application where you see you have a real-world fiat translation into platform currency. At any point, this currency can be swapped out for an appreciating asset. That's what people don't understand. So beta could literally just be their thing until they're ready to move forward into adopting, you know, their own appreciating currency. So you as a creator, like, this is what Dogecoin was supposed to be. Dogecoin never, ever, you know, amounted to anything. Like, when you, like, for me, I don't like calling things a failure, but when we talk about failure into creating value for artists, it was a joke. It was a tipping coin. And what was sad about Dogecoin was you have all these artists, all these NFT spaces, but and everyone talking about utility to come in, and you got Mark Cuban flirting, you got Elon Musk flirting with it. Well, those guys could have at any point built a market space like this and used Dogecoin to facilitate interactions or engagement through subscriptions or reoccurring sponsorship. They never did that. And that's why Dogecoin kind of like has a value based on those who are desperate enough to gain more based off of whatever earnings, you know, they reinvested after pulling out initial investment. Dogecoin could have bid this. Bitcoin could be this. They chose not to. Now you have obscure coins literally fulfilling, you know, the social parameters of inclusion that we want from, you know, a post-blockchain society in our market spaces. This is what they were supposed to be. And now you have something like, you know, just coins. That's all it is, waiting to be replaced by a crypto of appreciating value, in which case something like this is a great opportunity to try to engage in that fashion, to try, like, if you could get your currency accepted, you know, it's a game changer. There's nothing stopping these guys from allowing multiple crypto payments to facilitate the purchase of coins and vice versa. This is an entire ecosystem waiting to happen. Like, there's an entire economy right here. I can't make that up. So again, you know, when you hit trending, you're going to come across, you know, music, you're going to come across other forms of art. This is what I meant, like, when we talk about artists, this guy, let's find out who he is. Let's see how popping Jeremy is. Jeremy's got 92,000 views. He's got 2,300 subscribers. He's got 123 subscriptions. What I like about this platform, again, you can check out the full profile. And if you like the person, you can buy them a coffee. So whatever you think that's worth, right? Again, I'm not trying to disrespect Jeremy. If I could go buy Jeremy, you know, as much coffees, if you see Jeremy's profile, bless the man with coffee, okay? Make sure he has coffee for the month. Bless the man. Bless the man. But this is what I mean. Like, this is a native feature of the asset. You can just buy someone a coffee, because sometimes how we market it, like, hey, you know, if you appreciate the work, feel free to give a tip. Some people are apprehensive about, you know, scanning a QR code and, you know, sending any type of crypto. A lot of people don't know how to use the Ethereum naming service. The Ethereum naming service allows you to send over 109 different token types to, you know, whoever you're with, right? So when people are talking about like the Chivo wallet, like it was this, you know, grandstanding achievement, it's like, no, any of these people could have created a Coinbase wallet, for example, and received Bitcoin and received any cryptocurrency of their choice. It's just El Salvador's desire for sovereignty and to have their own platform, their own cryptocurrency wallet was necessary. But then at the same time too, Coinbase missed out on a huge opportunity to engage and facilitate that movement, right? It could have been the same Coinbase wallet, just with a different graphic layout, you know, stated as Chivo wallet, fully integratable with all the currencies available. But why didn't that happen? It's because people want to play gatekeeper. They don't want to enhance global adoption. I'm not saying that's what Coinbase wants. I'm simply saying they missed an opportunity to seize, you know, excellent opportunities in a Latin American market. Where El Salvador made a mistake in their process of things, and where El Salvador made a mistake in their process of things was not creating a wallet for all of Latin America. You know, just choosing their country. Because otherwise, you know, remember, Latin America is hugely underserved. When we go looking at the McKinsey report, one thing that was obvious in the McKinsey report was that when we talk about the differential between, you know, payment as a service and the market capture in the Asia Pacific, having totaled, I think, close to like $912 billion, North America, you know, is behind by, I think, $349 billion. And then you have EMA, so Eastern Europe, the Middle East, and Africa, they're down by $520 billion. But then you have Latin America, that's down by $750 billion. So they missed out on opportunities in market of almost $1 trillion, like $750 billion just was out there. It was in play. They could have made some money, but they made nothing. Based, unless we just look at, you know, typical business transactions from a payment as a service. So again, you know, it's that's, you know, Latin America is a really good emerging market, and it's going to be interesting to see what kind of value is created and how many jobs come from these wallets. Because, you know, if we're talking about 0% fees, well, without any reoccurring fees, you know, how do we create more opportunities for people, right? Sometimes you have to remember that, like, these 1% fees, even if it's 0.01% fees, on the grand scheme of things, when you're doing 100 million and billions of dollars in business, that 0.01% fee creates jobs down the road. It creates grant opportunities that are essentially jobs for people to enhance the overall experience when we discuss things of a post-blockchain, you know, like nature. So again, that's all I've got for y'all today. This has been another Big Black Crypto episode. And of course, I'm going to make sure you guys get the custom link so you can sign up and get involved in this, this unknown economy. If you really want to grow in this space, you know, again, you got so much opportunity. Here's a multidisciplinary artist, and she's got 304,000 views, 65,000 subscribers, and 126 subscriptions. So again, it's, if you want to learn more or grow or gain in this space, this is one of the easiest ways to do it. Just come check out, see what people are doing, and ask yourself what you could do to, you know, create an experience for your own audience. So thank you kindly. Again, this has been another Big Black Crypto episode, and I hope that I've been able to, you utilize for your community and in spaces in which your audience is frequent. Thank you and have a great day. Ciao for now.